Our first guest tonight is a character actor that you're sure to recognize. This man has appeared in over 100 motion pictures, including Rawhide, High Noon, and Gunfight at the OK Corral, and can currently be seen right here on this network in a program called Easy Street. He was once described as the roughest, toughest, dirtiest movie heavy ever. A perfect guest. Please welcome Jack Elam. Thank you very much for being with us tonight.
Yes.
The roughest, toughest, dirtiest movie heavy ever.
Yes, right.
Yeah. How nasty a guy could you be in films? Like, do you remember one that was particularly out of control?
Well, probably the roughest would be the one that got the whole thing going for me, which would be Rawhide, 1950 or 1949 with Tyrone Power and Susan Hayward. Mm-hmm. And in that one, I had the privilege of shooting at the feet of a little one-year-old baby to make her dance.
Oh, God.
And I killed all the rest of the heavies in it and went on from there to some really dirty stuff.
I was just warming up, were you? And did you die in most of these films eventually?
I'd say about 90% of them, yes,
yeah.
I did.
Yeah. Did you shoot guys in the back, that kind of thing,
too?
It's
the only place.
Yeah.
Anything else kind of stupid.
Yeah. And how did you get into acting? I know it wasn't your first choice as a profession.
No, I was an auditor in the picture business, and because of an eye problem, I had to, you know, get another job.
So you're working over figures all day, looking
at long
columns.
That's right, and that's pretty hard on you know, if you have an eye problem. So I had to figure something.
It's easier to shoot at the feet of a baby, isn't it?
That's easy.
Yeah.
A little more fun too. So I had to pick up, you know, something that I could do that I didn't have to use the eyes so much.
Uh-huh.
And I knew the picture business, and I had some contacts. I was able to, you know, buy two or three roles to get started.
So you got yourself in that way.
I got myself in
pretty
that way.
Pretty good thinking on your part. And this is a. Let's take a look at some of these films. Now, if I mention a movie title, can you remember the plot and the people you worked with and anecdotes about the film?
Some, maybe.
Let's try a couple here. No, your first film was The Sundowners,
well,
is that right?
There were about three or four before that, but that...
Was Rawhide before The Sundowners?
No, the Sundowners was before Rawhide. That's one of those that I bought my job. It starred young Barrymore, John Barrymore Jr. He was 16 at the time.
Yeah. And that's the one where you said, give me a job and I'll help you with your budget.
That's right. I got the financing for the picture in exchange for doing the role in the picture.
High Noon?
Well, now, High Noon, the problem about saying I'm in High Noon is that by then I'd done about 30 or 40 heavies.
Mm-hmm.
And so when people say, well, you were in High Noon, weren't you? Oh, yeah. And they think of me as one of those three guys that did in the shootout, mm-hmm. which was not true at all. I was the drunk that Cooper threw out of the jail at High Noon mm-hmm. and it went in the bar, which is befitting my character, of course.
And you, let's see, Rancho Notorious?
Marlena Dietrich, yes,
yeah,
beautiful.
Yeah. And
from Marlena Dietrich now to Lonnie Anderson.
It's a pretty good deal. Any of these others? Gunfight at OK Corral?
Well, yes, that was Kirk Douglas and Burt Lancaster. Who else? I forget who. Oh, John Ireland, yes. That was about 1950. What is it? Do you have years on there to say anything?
Let's see. Well, we're in Final Jeopardy now, Jack.
Oh.
And I need your answer in the form of a question, so...
Oh, you do.
Let's see.
How did you like what I did in Sea Snake's Maiden?
Are there parts that you turned down that you could kick yourself about? This is a standard talk show question.
Yeah. Well,
but did that occur in your career?
Yes, it sure did. But when I started, I thought that the part was as big as how much you said,
mm-hmm.
you know, how many lines you had. And I, you know, you count your lines. I got 27 lines. It's a pretty damn good part, you know. If you got any less, you'd... Anyway, I was doing a picture called Jubal Troop up in Colorado. And I got a script sent to me for my next picture by the agent. It had, mm-hmm. I counted the lines, and there were only 8 lines. Now, in Jubal, I had 22 lines.
Yeah, so you thought you were taking a step down.
I'm not going to do that. That's garbage. Cut me down. The picture was Shane, and it made a star out of Jack Palance.
Yeah, so you learned pretty quickly there.
I learned that it isn't how many lines you got. It's how it's shot or how you do them.
All right, we'll do a commercial. Thanks, Paul. 1955, Cattle Queen of Montana.
Uh-huh.
What comes to mind there?
This is President's Day.
Yeah, that's right.
That comes to mind. That the leading man in that picture was a man named Ronald Reagan.
Yeah.
Well, my My recollection of Ronald Reagan, he bawled me out at dinner one night for about 20 minutes for not taking an active part in the activities of the Screen Actors Guild. He was president of the Screen Actors Guild then. And I was very happy that after dinner he spent 20 minutes on the floor looking for his contact lenses.
What kind of man was he to work with? Was a nice guy, pleasant?
Very nice, very pleasant. I don't know. I don't remember his acting, but I know he was a very pleasant guy personally.
I don't think anyone's going to remember his presidency either, as the way things are going. It's a joke. Hey, now wait a minute. Oh, no. Now, are you still? You mentioned that you drink a little. You drink, right?
Well, a lot, if I have a chance. Uh-huh. You haven't made me an offer.
Well, we just busted the only container of beer we had here a minute ago. You go into bars? Is this you stay at home? I mean, what do you do when you're recreational drinking, right?
Recreational drinking. No, I drink just habit for me, you know.
Now, can you work while you're drinking? You probably don't do that, do you?
Oh, yes.
Oh, you do?
It doesn't. Better.
Yeah.
My problem right now, 3 or 4 drinks, and this would be duck soup.
Yeah. So now when you show up, you usually, what do you have when you're working?
When I'm working drinks?
Yeah.
Well, I don't drink till 12 o'clock at lunch. Uh-huh. I drink a few drinks at lunch, 3 or 4, and then...
That's important for the kids just starting out, isn't it?
Yeah. Because
get a good breakfast.
Get a good breakfast,
yeah, that's
and then
right.
Get some nice whiskey in you at lunch, and then... I don't drink again until 5 o'clock. Uh-huh. 5 o'clock, hell or high water, whether we're shooting or not, get the out.
And you play Liar's Poker?
Liar's Poker, yes. We play that all the time or any
big
time.
Money? You play just
no,
for the bill.
Dollar bill, just for a dollar bill. Liar's Poker is only good with dollar bills. You get it too high, then it's kind of stupid.
Have you ever played for bigger stakes than a dollar?
Yes, I have. I only play for $100 bills with... Audie Murphy and I always played with $100 bills because he was quite a gambler, and he and I were kind of washed out. We'd end up about even, so we could do it. And Don Siegel, the director, he and I always played with.
You remember the biggest pot that you won or lost?
No, you could only win the bill.
Oh, but
you play Liar's Poker, you can win that $100.
Right.
Or the biggest, the most I ever won, one day I know on the Gunsmoke, I did about 25 Gunsmokes, guest shots. And one day the makeup lady had a boyfriend, a hot shot in... You know, with black and white fancy shoes and everything that showed up on the set. And he was putting me down. He says, I'd play. I wouldn't this dollar bill. Because we were playing for dollar bills. Mm-hmm. And he says, hell, I wouldn't touch anything less than $100 bills. And I said, well, no. He says, come on, you're chicken coward. So anyway, I always have a few dollars on me in case an emergency like that arises. And so I got out a $100 bill. And he had a wad. And it was about 5 $100 bills on the top.
Wow.
And it took about 5 minutes, and I bought drinks for the company for days.
You cleaned him out. Now, do you try and find a bill and hang on to it? Is that
that's not nice.
Now, I don't know how to
people
play
do that. Yeah, well, I got to do the glasses for that.
All right.
No,
can I just give you a bill and we'll play here?
Any bill. I bet you've got...
I have no
you
idea
did it.
How you
come
play.
On, you did it. You
I have no
it.
No, I don't know how you
no,
play.
No, you loaded
I don't.
It. You don't? Okay.
I don't.
You look like my producer, and I don't believe a thing
All right,
say.
Okay, how do you play here?
The letter... First, you say the initials. Now, I have an IA. What are your initials?
Oh,
that's to see who goes first.
There's millions of initials.
No, there's
on
only
bill.
One at the top and the number.
Huh? Oh, I have an F.
F, you're... Okay, you're first. Now, you... It's the combined numbers on our two bills that counts, right? And so, you can bid anything you want. You don't have to have it. I have to beat that bid or challenge you. When I challenge you, if you do have it in the two bills, you win. If you don't have it, then I win, right? Uh-huh. And we keep going up and up until somebody challenges. You just bid something.
Okay.
What do you have? Pair of deuces?
No.
No deuces, huh? No, I'll be sure not bid them. Anybody know how this
is? I just don't know how you play this. $100 and my house. I don't know. What are we... No.
You see, there's 8 numbers on every bill.
Yeah.
I would say, for example, with this bill, I have 3 7s.
No, I think I can beat
now,
some of those.
No, I have no 7s. So I'm hoping that you'll go to 4 7s.
All right, yeah, let's go to 4 7s.
They gave you a loaded bill, didn't they?
No, look, I could win on those two, a pair of 4s.
That's a pair of 4s.
Yeah, I could win there, right?
Bid a pair of 4s.
I bid a pair of 4s.
3 4s.
Okay.
You got to beat that or challenge.
Well,
I've seen your bill.
Challenge.
It's not fair.
I challenge.
No, you see, I have 1 4 and you have 2, so 3 4.
So
I would have won. No, no.
I'd bet 3 4. I don't understand the game.
That's why I want to play this.
No. Okay. So, but that's a lot of
anyway,
fun.
Anyway, it's a great game. It's a good time passing.
This show, it's Easy Street, right?
Easy Street, right.
It's on here at NBC, right?
It was on last... It's on Sunday night at 8 o'clock.
Yeah.
They moved us around a little. We were on at 8:30 for a while, and then they... But 8 o'clock is our
Things going time. All right for you?
Yeah, they're going...
Is this your first TV show that you're doing, Easy Street?
No. Yeah, no, it's the first one with an audience. We shoot on Fridays with a live audience. I've done a series before, three different series before. I did the Dakotas and the Texas Wheelers and Struck by Lightning, but none with an audience. Yeah. This is a three-camera live audience show Friday night.
Well, good luck to you. Nice meeting you, Jack. Thank you very much for being here.